Kaylen, and I'm the Medical Outreach Director for the Mesothelioma Center. In today's video, I wanted to go over some differences between pleural and peritoneal mesothelioma, specifically for those families facing a peritoneal mesothelioma diagnosis, since there are far fewer resources for this type of mesothelioma. It's estimated by the American Cancer Society that there are about 3,000 cases of newly diagnosed mesothelioma patients in the U.S. each year. About 20% of these cases take place in the abdomen, which results in a diagnosis of peritoneal mesothelioma. Like pleural mesothelioma, peritoneal mesothelioma is mainly caused by exposure to asbestos fibers, which can be unknowingly ingested or inhaled. However, peritoneal mesothelioma is a very different diagnosis, with a different set of treatment options and an overall better prognosis. The main difference between peritoneal and pleural mesothelioma is the origin and location of the cancer. Pleural mesothelioma takes place in the chest, specifically the pleural lining around the lungs. Peritoneal mesothelioma takes place in the abdomen, specifically on the peritoneum, which lines the stomach cavity. Diagnostics and surgery for these two different types of mesothelioma differ greatly. Diagnosing pleural mesothelioma involves a thoracic surgeon, who would extract fluid as well as tissue from the chest area, send it off to the lab for it to be diagnosed definitively as mesothelioma. If surgery is determined to be an option, the thoracic surgeon would remove the pleural lining on the outside of the lung and potentially also the lung itself, diaphragm, and a portion of the lining of the heart. For peritoneal mesothelioma, a diagnosis is found by a general surgeon or a surgical oncologist. They would also remove the fluid and the tissue to get a definitive diagnosis, and if surgery is considered an option, they would debulk the tumors to remove as much of the malignancy as possible. One form of treatment available to patients with peritoneal mesothelioma is called hypothermic intraoperative chemotherapy. This treatment involves applying a heated mixture of the chemotherapy agents commonly used to treat mesothelioma directly to the site of the cancer during the operation. This type of therapy has been successful in treating many abdominal cancers and can be linked to a median survival rate of 7 years for patients with peritoneal mesothelioma who have the surgery as well as intraoperative treatment. This technology is still being developed for patients with thoracic cancers. So for pleural mesothelioma patients, it's only available in a couple places around the country. If you'd like to learn more about the differences between pleural and peritoneal mesothelioma, as well as treatment, specialists, and information for your specific diagnosis, please feel free to contact me. Thanks for watching and hope you join us next time.